If you're looking for a one-stop email marketing tool that can create email campaigns, send newsletters, organize email lists, track and analyze results, Klaviyo is the answer. My name is Lisa and welcome to Learn with GemPages. In today's video, we're going to learn how to integrate Klaviyo on GemPages and how to set up the essential signup form in Klaviyo. You can use the timestamps listed to navigate this video. Let's dive right in. Install on Shopify Store. First, head over to the Shopify App Store and search for Klaviyo and select Add App and then Install App. Next, we need to enter our username and password. If you don't have an account yet, you need to hit Let's Get Started to sign in for a new one. Now we're going to enter all the business addresses and click Continue to move on to the next step. We also need to fill in our sender information. The sender name is our store name in Shopify. For the sender email, look to the right to figure out what the sender email is and how to change it. After completing a few more questions, we'll be redirected to the app's dashboard. Integrate on GemPages. Next, we're going back to the GemPages editor to install the Klaviyo element from the library. Click on the Integration tab on the left sidebar and search for Klaviyo, then hit Add Element. Now the element has been added to the left sidebar and is ready for use. Types of signup forms. There's no doubt that Klaviyo is more than just signup forms. However, it is the most used feature on GemPages. We'll delve into it in today's videos. Heading back to the Klaviyo dashboard, click on the Signup Forms tab, then hit the Create Signup Form button. There are three form types you can choose from. Pop-up. Pop-ups appear in the middle of a browser window, which makes them eye-catching and high-converting. However, going too far or wrong timing can be annoying or distracting to potential customers. Flyout. Flyouts are less intrusive than pop-ups, but still noticeable, as they fly into the edge of the page rather than in the middle. They generally allow a visitor to keep browsing without interacting with or closing the form. Embed forms are embedded on a specific section of your site, like your footer. Consider including an embed form in your footer in addition to any pop-up or flyout forms you build. Set up from targeting and behavior. Now we're going to create an embedded signup form. Just like GemPages, we can reuse the pre-designed form or build it yourself from the ground up. After naming the form and choosing the category, hit Create Form. On the left sidebar, there are three main sections, including styles, targeting and behavior, and ad blocks. However, most of us stumble at the configuring targeting and behavior settings. We're going to clear up all the confusion. Let's get into it. First up is devices. You can display the form on desktop, mobile devices, or both. A form set up to appear on desktops will also appear on tablets. Moving down to targeting by visitor, you can aim the form at a specific group based on particular conditions. Show to all visitors means the form will appear for all site visitors. Don't show to existing Klaviyo profiles. The form will only appear to visitors who are unknown to Klaviyo. Show to visitors in certain lists and segments. The form will appear to visitors who are members of any of the lists or segments you select. Don't show to visitors in certain lists and segments. The form will show to all the visitors and leave out the selected groups. Next up is targeting by URL. To know how to target visitors correctly by URL, we need to understand the Shopify URL structure first. Let's look at an example. This is the domain. Coming along is page types that could be pages, collections, products, or blogs, and end up with a handle. Now we're going to differentiate between containing and exact matching. Containing includes any URL with part of the value you input. For example, if we input the domain, this will include product and blog page types. If we input domain with page type, such as product, all of the product pages will be targeted, such as Blue Gem Cleansing Water, Blue Gem Hydration Mask, and so on. Exacting matching means that you can target one specific URL. For example, Blue Gem Cleansing Water will include only that exact URL, and will not include Blue Gem Hydration Mask. Don't show on certain URLs will have the same logic, but in reverse. Targeting by location. You can choose to show or not show a form to visitors based on their location. This will be useful when you want to include specific information for people in Asia, but browsers in another region can't see it. Hit Publish to apply the changes on the live page and copy the form code, which we'll use later on. Back to the GemPages editor page, drag and drop the Klaviyo element to the position you want. Click on the element under the Form Code section, insert the code we just got earlier, hit Publish, and check out the result on the live page. If you have further questions, please leave them in the comment section below. And give it a thumbs up, that helps the video be seen by other people. Make sure you've subscribed and hit the notification bell, then you won't miss out on any future content. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye!